We now look at how the QR factorization can be used to solve the linear least squares problem. So recall that we're given a system AX equals B, except that B is not necessarily in the column space of A, and therefore the best we can hope for is to compute the best solution to this problem. And what we saw was that X was given by this formula right here. It was actually the X that solved this problem, but with the right-hand side replaced by the projection of B onto the column space of A. If A has linearly independent columns, which is coincidentally the condition under which A transpose A inverse exists, then we can compute the QR factorization of matrix A. And recall that Q transpose Q was equal to the identity because the whole purpose of the game was to compute mutually orthonormal vectors. X then is equal to this formula right here, which is really the pseudo inverse of A times the vector B. If we now plug in QR everywhere where we have an A, we get this formula right here. Now let's focus on this right here. We multiply two matrices together and then transpose. That's the same as transposing each of the matrices and then reversing their order. That applies there, and it applies here. And so what we get is this right here. Okay, so this here is this QR quantity transposed, and so is this. But now what we notice is that we get Q transpose Q. But Q transpose Q is the identity. So we get this. But now we can take away our parentheses, and as a matter of fact, we can place our parentheses right here. And we notice that R inverse transpose, R transpose, is just the identity. So that goes away. And we're left with this formula right here. Now, we don't actually want to invert matrix R. What we want to recognize is that we can form a new right-hand side, Q transpose B. And with that right-hand side, we can solve the upper triangular system Rx equal to that vector, because remember, R was an upper triangular matrix. So now we have an alternative way for solving X, which is the best solution to Ax approximately equal to B. So in summary, if we want to solve Ax approximately equal to B, one thing we can do is compute the QR factorization of A. We can then update the right-hand side by multiplying it on the left by Q transpose, followed by a solve with the upper triangular matrix R. And this all works as long as the columns of A are linearly independent. Now, if the columns of A are not linearly independent, we're getting into an advanced topic, and that's beyond the scope of this course.